economic embargo. In the Arabic and English was very clear, but in Denmark newspaper it was slightly, you know, the translation was. So again, the Prime Minister also gave a half-hearted apology. And the newspaper, the chief editor said that what we wrote is not against the Danish laws, but because it hurt the Muslims in different parts of the world, we apologized. That means they're giving an apology, but with condition. According to Danish laws, it is not prohibited. Means we didn't break any rule of Denmark country, but because it hurt millions of Muslims throughout the world, we are sorry for that. For example, if in a religion rape is allowed, and if I rape anyone's sister and say that, see, in my religion raping is allowed, but I'm sorry if I hurt you. I mean, you can't say in my country it's allowed. If it is wrong for humanity, it is wrong, whether it's there in your religion or not, whether it's there in your country or not. So imagine someone says, my religion raping a woman is allowed, and I rape your mother, and I rape your sister, and I rape your wife. If you felt hurt, I'm sorry. Is it logical? No. What is wrong for human beings is wrong. And it's made haram when it is wrong for everyone as a whole, or for the majority, then it's haram. If it's wrong only for a minority, then it's not haram. For example, sugar is bad for those who have diabetes. So for that, it's not haram for everyone, haram only for that individual. So similarly, the apology again was half-hearted. But there was a big ripple in Denmark. But now again, $800 million for America is nothing. So if you use this strategy for America, it's useless. But the strategy used last year, where all American products were banned, was a big loss, several billions of dollars for America, which is again. So when you put a loss, if the person is big and the loss is very small, it may not cause any effect. But $800 million for Denmark is a big amount. For America, it may not be a big amount. So when you use a strategy of putting any economic embargo or banning any product, like if, for example, we say that let's ban the Denmark products in India, it will hardly cause any loss. It will not even cause a scratch to the economy of Denmark. Though India is a big country, 1 billion people, Muslims, maybe 160, 180 million, because we aren't big consumers of Denmark product. But Middle East is. One of the major exports goes to Middle East. So depending upon the strategy, this strategy did work very well. Immediately, there was reaction, there was apology, etc. As far as political thing is concerned, the fifth strategy, political, many of the Muslim countries objected. The Muslim ambassadors, they went on the 20th of October and told the Prime Minister what this is wrong, but he thought that Muslim country. Now what has happened, immediately Saudi Arabia has taken its ambassador back. They called the ambassador from Denmark saying we don't want there, immediately. And many Muslim countries are demanding that we don't want the embassy of Denmark in our country. Now there's a political pressure. So now they're apologizing, they're saying sorry. So alhamdulillah, summa alhamdulillah, reaction of the Muslim community throughout the world was alhamdulillah. Using the last strategy, violence, there was in some countries like in Indonesia, they barged into the embassy of Denmark, they broke their windows, they threw rotten eggs and tomatoes. In Iraq, they took the Denmark flag and they stamped on it, they burnt it. But somewhere in Palestine, they kidnapped a German thinking that he is a person from Denmark and gave a death threat, etc. But they came to know it was German, so they gave to the police of Palestine. In some places, like in London, they took a big banner that if you don't stop it, 7-7 will take place again in London, indicating that a suicide bombing will take place, which I feel that this is now again going outside the fold of Islam, the sixth strategy part of it. Other five strategies, alhamdulillah, sixth, little bit burning of flags, some may say no, some may say yes, but can't say totally haram. But killing innocent people is haram in Islam. So here we analyze, one thing good that took place was that the American people didn't publish it at all. UK government by itself, they spoke against Denmark. All the other European countries, most of them supported Denmark, saying it is freedom of speech. But Jack Straw, the foreign minister of UK, he said there is freedom of speech, but freedom of speech doesn't mean you can attack any religion or you can defame someone. Same thing with America. America condemned it. Why? Because maybe all these past effects that took place in America and UK, so they're more political wise. Not that I'm condoning what they did earlier. But now they realize that all these small issues of caricature, the loss is billions of dollars. Even BBC. So all these people, especially in USA and UK, they took a stand against what happened in Denmark. They were in favor of the Muslims. But the other European countries, Germany, Italy, they said it's freedom of speech is there, so what's wrong? In France, This was published in France. The chief editor of the newspaper that published the article in France was removed, sacked. In France. France again took a middle stance. In Jordan also someone reproduced it, a Muslim person. He said, I wanted to make Muslims aware what is going wrong, but even he was sacked. Here we realize that our reaction should be such that basically we should clarify the misconception. Now if we take to hardcore violence, killing innocent people, it again gives a negative picture of Islam. But as far as the other first five strategies I said, is the best, no one can object. If you are saying the freedom of speech, we have freedom to write back, reply in the media. We have freedom to put a silent protest. We have freedom to boycott your goods. It's our choice. We don't want to eat Danish cookies. We want to file a legal case. We want to have a political, we say, if that's freedom, our politics, we will cut ties with you. And this, mashallah, we did not take place earlier. This, I feel, is one of the first few times that, mashallah, the Muslim Ummah as a whole, they reacted very well. Not that immediate reaction was there. They gave them time to Denmark, the Prime Minister. This took place 20th of January, and the Muslim reacted, no. First, we gave them time. And then when it blew out of proportion, it was reprinted in the other European newspaper. To prevent it from happening, this thing, I feel, happened very well, except for the few incidents which were outside the violence limit that Islam permits. Otherwise, as a whole, I feel, mashallah, the Muslim community as a whole, they reacted very well. And the newspapers, whether in the Gulf countries, whether the channels or mashallah, as a whole, I feel the reaction was very good. But each one gave their strategy. But the Muslim should be told as a whole that the various strategies are available. Though each country took one strategy, alhamdulillah, but as a whole, if you are aware, on an individual level, here sitting, we should do what we can for Islam. So at least we can reply on the internet, write an article, whether they publish in the newspaper or not, pamphlet, whatever it is, help someone. So media, everyone can take part. If you feel a peaceful protest will make a difference, do it. Some part it may not make a difference because the country having a relationship with that country is very small, so they're least bothered about it. But if the economic thing is there, then they're bothered that the embassy should function properly, there should not be any backlash. So, seeing all this scenario, if we take the strategy and give a reply, inshallah, inshallah, we'll see to it that we will be able to clarify the misconception in the right way and promote Islam in the right way. Hope that answers the question.